Back for another segment is mayoral candidate Leo Savage. What you got, kid?
Okay, you're mayor. You just won.
Thank you. Congratulations. Yeah. Just throw a party. We
got second floor. You're in the elevator. You go into your desk. What are the first three things Mayor Savage does?
First thing Mayor Savage will do is excuse our police chief. That's the very first thing. Without doubt. Next thing, where you
can't fire him. So you,
yes, I can. I can relocate him. I can actually
demote
take him. Yes.
Okay.
I already have several people that I have in mind as far as a police chief. Mm-hmm. And the closer I get, I think I'm going to try to narrow that down. I may even walk in with my police chief. Now, that person will still have to take, because it's a civil job, they're mm-hmm. going to have to take the test, and as everyone will.
And second thing you do?
Second thing, I'm rounding up every one of our department heads. You know, I'm going to let them know exactly what's going to happen for the next 2 weeks.
Are
I'll
they
be
getting pink
in.
Slips? Or are they
no,
getting they, interviewed?
That will get reevaluated. Okay. Everybody's going to get reevaluated. I will give them opportunity to prove to me what they've done this year, and I want to find out what their plans are for 19.
And your third thing you're going to do?
Third thing? Good question. Third thing, I believe what I want to do is call for the third-party audits for all of our departments.
Those are costly. The water and sewer department audit
yes.
is $180,000.
Well, I tell you, even right now, if you look at the one that they awarded the contract to, I mean, there's, you know, there's odd ties into to the prior administration. Matter of fact, it was prior administration's accountant is who they awarded that to. So will I trust that? No. So we'll do our own. I think that in order to, and it's like with anybody else, if you come in, you want a clean slate. I want to know what I've got. And
your,
I know
your CAO, is he fired?
Yes. We're going to get a new CAO for sure. Now, mm-hmm. I won't do that probably day one, but it will be, or day two or three. But that will be a process as well. It'll be an interview process. I do have one or two people that I'm certainly looking at there for a CAO job. I mean, one I'm highly impressed with. So, you know, I've got that, certainly that opportunity. You, in order to run a city, again, you have got to surround yourself with incredible people. And that's what Shreveport deserves. That's what we have to have.
You know, one of the things that I guess Erin brought it up at her city council forum last evening, you may have been asked previously, and we asked Adrian yesterday, and he said, I'm no fan of taxes, but I can't promise no new taxes. With the tax base of Shreveport diminishing, and that basically there's nobody that disputes that, would Mayor Leo Savage, would candidate Leo Savage take the no new tax pledge?
I don't think I can say no new taxes. I think we have to look at the whole picture. If you, Matt, Erin, and I went to dinner and it was $100, and we were all paying Dutch, and we were going to pay $25 a piece. Well, you know, Matt got a call and had to run out, had an emergency. Well, that same bill has to be paid, and it's now going to cost us $33.33. That's what's happened. You know, we've lost so many people, about 8,000 people. We were at 2001, we had 201,000 people. And now today, last year, the U.S. Census Bureau said we have 192,000. So we have lost a considerable amount of people. So our burdens are the same things are happening, the same things. We need water. We need trash pickup. Everything that we have to spend is the same thing. What I would love to do is go in there and scrub our budget. You know, you've got to have somebody that can go in there. If you look right now, and again, all this information is online, but if you look at our general fund is the largest piece of pie. If you look at on a pie chart, it is massive. And I don't like that word general fund. You know, I want everything. I want it down to it's a sliver. That general fund is a sliver, but people know what that sliver is. You know, everything has to be accounted for. I think once we divide all that up and we figure out exactly where all the money has been going, and I promise you that I will not, I'll make sure that the money we spend is going to be investments, and they're only going to be something that's going to be crystal clear, and the people of Shreveport know it.
We have
to be transparent.
We got time for one more.
Speaking of the budget,
go ahead.
I'm a rainy day girl. What is your goal for our reserve fund, which right now, I don't know if you know, is critically low?
Yes.
What is Leo Savage's goal to keep in Shreveport's reserve fund?
Well, as you know, going into 2019, the current administration, oddly enough, they are going to create the budget for 2019. Now, working with the city council, we can actually alter that. I would at least like to first, and it's a super question, and I would love to be able to answer it specifically to you, but I really think that we have got to look at the entire budget and see exactly what's going on. Rainy day is, you have to have that. You know, what are we going to need the rainy day for? But let's make sure that we have enough. And I can't, out of $488 million that we have now, you know, if you look at that budget, you know, is it enough? Is a million enough? Probably. You know, but should we try to shoot for a million? Absolutely. Will that happen the first year the way they have the budget laid out? I don't think so. But I do think that we have to trend towards that, because you never know what will happen. But we do have funds. There are funds in there. I mean, they can pluck out funds for a lot of things.
Have you read the budget, the 2018
yes.
budget?
Yes.
Okay.
I have.
And the new one's coming out this weekend. She's supposed to send it out.
Okay, good. Well, I'm looking forward to that one.
Okay.
And again, that's going to be for 2019.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's something that I know I'm going to have to work. I'm going to have to start on. I won't say that I'm going to have to comply with that. But, you know, working with the city council, I've already talked to several council members of, you know, what we can do, how we can do, and that can be altered. But we have to have a good vision, a good direction for our city. You know, if we look, I don't want to be the mayor that comes in and says, okay, in 4 years, this is where we're going to be. Although I want to have a great plan to do that, and we have great plans of what we will look like in 4 years. But we have to look, you know, 8 years, 12 years, 20 years down the line. You know, what will Shreveport look like in 20 years? We can't be short-sighted, and if we still plan short-sighted, that's what we're going to get. What we're going to do is wake up one day, and we're going to have what we have today.